krizi göçü tetikliyor. İklim krizinin etkileri dünya çapında giderek daha fazla hissediliyor. Mevsim normallerinin dışında seyreden sıcaklıklar, orman yangınları, kuraklık ve sel gibi aşırı hava olayları insanların yaşamlarını olumsuz etkiliyor. Bu olaylar milyonlarca insanı evlerinden ediyor ve göç etmek zorunda bırakıyor. İklim krizinin en çok etkilediği bölgeler arasında Sahra Altı Afrika, Güney Asya ve Güneydoğu Asya yer alıyor. Bu bölgeler, zaten kırılgan olan ekosistemlere sahip ve iklim krizinin etkilerine karşı çok savunmasız durumda. İklim krizinin göç üzerindeki etkisi giderek daha fazla hissediliyor. 2018 yılında, iklim değişikliğinden kaynaklanan nedenlerle dünya çapında 25 milyon kişi yerinden edildi. Bu sayı, 2030 yılına kadar 200 milyona ulaşabileceği tahmin ediliyor. İklim krizinin göç üzerindeki etkisi, sadece sayısal olarak değil, aynı zamanda niteliksel olarak da önemli. İklim değişikliğinden kaynaklanan göç, genellikle zorla göç olarak gerçekleşiyor. Bu, insanların evlerini terk etmek zorunda kalmaları ve yeni bir yere yerleşmeleri anlamına geliyor. Bu durum, insanların yaşamlarında büyük bir yıkıma neden oluyor ve onları ciddi zorluklarla karşı karşıya bırakıyor. İklim krizi, dünyanın karşı karşıya olduğu en büyük sorunlardan biri. Bu soruna çözüm bulmak, insanlığın ortak görevidir. İklim krizinin etkilerini azaltmak ve göçü azaltmak için tüm ülkeler birlikte hareket etmelidir. İklim krizine karşı mücadele. İklim krizine karşı mücadele etmek için tüm ülkeler birlikte hareket etmelidir. Bu mücadelede aşağıdaki adımlar atılabilir: sera gazı emisyonlarını azaltmak, yenilenebilir enerji kaynaklarına yatırım yapmak, enerji verimliliğini artırmak, ormanları korumak, su kaynaklarını korumak, aşırı hava olaylarının etkilerine karşı hazırlıklı olmak. İklim krizine karşı mücadele, tüm insanlığın geleceği için önemlidir. Bu mücadelede, tüm ülkeler birlikte hareket etmelidir.
Temperature which makes people go away. And there is a kind of mechanical link. And this is one of the main results of 20 years of research, that it is much more complex. And that's also interesting, but that's sometimes difficult to explain to the politicians and to the population. It is an issue, definitely. We have to really to take into account that there might be large forced displacements of population as a consequence of climate change, but not necessarily in all circumstances all around the world in the same way. We also have cases where, for example, there is a shock, drought, population are moving less than before, are migrating less than before, not more, but less. So it's a complex issue. And so that's why it's important to really to study on a case-by-case basis this phenomenon, not to kind of make a kind of general statement, which did appear in the past in some press reports, that simply millions of people are gonna migrate and this is a danger and we should be we should protect also some countries from those migration. These kind of oversimplifications are dangerous. It's always good to make more research, but I think there is a process, there is an ongoing process. And I don't think there are urgent specific political action needed regarding specifically the issue of mobility and migration. What is necessary is our increased efforts regarding climate change in general. That's the emergency, and mobility and migration has to be taken into account, but it should also not be considered as the main problem. I mean, the main problem is much more general than mobility and migration. It is a way to show that there is an issue to talk about migration, but I think the danger is that some countries might conclude from the link between climate change and migration that there are going to be more and more and more and more migrants, and that they should simply build walls to protect themselves against the migrants. And this is not the case. I mean, we have to fear climate change. It's really a danger, and we have to fight climate change. But we should not fear the migrants. The migrants are not the problem, not necessarily the problem. The problem is climate change.
So yes, of course, there is a relationship between climate change and migration. If we look at the length of time that it's been on the international agenda, you have to go back all the way to the 80s, mm-hmm. When it began to be called, in particular, climate refugee. That was the first kind of global policy framing of the issue. And that then kind of morphed into climate migration more generally around the early 2000s. And around the early 2000s is when you start to get the first major figures. If you look at the maps of climate migration around the world, it tends to be assumed that most of it will happen in the global south. So like in sub-Saharan Africa and in places like in South Asia and even Southeast Asia, and these kind of areas are supposed to be very vulnerable. That's not an accident. That's also about economics. It's also about global and local inequalities. Mm-hmm. But the relationship between climate change and migration varies in how strong it is, but it also has a lot of other variables in between. Economics is very important, but generally this is seen as something that will affect global southern countries. Climate doesn't act on people directly. It acts on communities, mm-hmm. And societies. So those social and physical and economic and community relationships are very important. So, the most difficult and dangerous part is certainly for the migrants themselves, because we're living in a context which is very hostile to migration. Well, only I would say it's very important to think critically, to think carefully about the way that we're told about climate migrants and climate migration. Because the kind of the global story of climate migration is generally of a kind of threatening, displaced group, of a huge group of millions of people who are coming to kind of threaten the livelihoods of better off countries. That is not really that close to the reality. In fact, you have just a lot of people who are being made much poorer by climate change, who are moving to find new jobs and new roles. Most of that movement is internal, and where it is international, if we can strengthen people's communities, strengthen social safety nets in the global south and in climate vulnerable countries, that is the long-term solution to adapt to the problems that we're facing under climate change.